Hi, I'm Scott Sheldon, and welcome to this episode of Winegazer. Thank you so much for tuning in. So I hope you had a great holiday, great New Year's, and I'm really excited. Got a lot of great stuff. It's going to be going down in 2012 with Winegazer. I want to share with you just a few things. Got some road trips coming up. Going to do some interviews with winemakers. A couple battles going down. California Pinot Noir battle, $50 and under. Petite Syrah battle, California wines again, $20 and under. So it should be very interesting episodes. And also doing a little spotlight on Côte du Rhône and some of the values and quality wines coming from that part of France. So stay tuned for that stuff. Today we are focusing on wines coming from Santa Barbara County. If you're not familiar with Santa Barbara County, it's about an hour and a half north of Los Angeles. Known as the California Riviera for its beautiful beaches, great restaurants and hotels, exquisite weather, and also some real fine winemaking going on. There's some tasting rooms downtown where you can go hang out and just like half a mile from the beach, kick back, have some wine, and it's a little alternative to, you know, the Napa, Sonoma thing. And I do recommend checking it out for sure. So, got some wines here. If you haven't heard, that's what we do on the show. We do taste wine and then talk about them, rank them up a little bit. 2009 Carr Pinot Noir comes from the Turner Vineyard located in the northern part of the Santa Rita Hills. Rolls in at $45 US, 249 cases produced, and 12 months in French oak. The clones used in this wine. Clones 113, 777, and Pommard, in case you're keeping score at home. So, Turner Vineyard, located in the northern part of the Santa Rita Hills, and they have south-facing slopes, sandy soil, real cool climate, great conditions for growing Pinot Noir. And this is, by the way, 100% Pinot Noir while I pour this. Santa Rita Hills, this appellation is known for dark, concentrated Pinot Noir, and what's interesting is why I focus on saying 100% Pinot Noir. There has been a lot of things going on in California recent years trying to give more oomph to some Pinot Noirs. People are blending in Syrah, blending in some other types of grapes, and here in California you can have Pinot Noir right here on this label and have up to 25% of any other grape in this bottle right here. So 25% is like a whole glass of wine. So you could basically have 25% of this bottle be anything. 75% Pinot Noir, you can call it Pinot Noir, no problem in California. That's the way we roll. So, glance at the color, quite. It's actually clear, you can see through, a little medium garnet color. Let's give it a smell. So, nice cherry cola coming through. It's the first thing that I really pick up on in this wine. Again, 12 months in French oak. I think I already said that. Tart cherries, and also there's like a potpourri of like crushed dried flowers, maybe some violets or rose petals. Really nice, very floral. And, you know, it's not burning the nose, 14.5% alcohol, again, on this wine, but it's very pleasant on the nose, not overpowering at all. Let's give it a taste. Strawberries coming through, some rhubarb. Definitely a red fruit on the palate. There's some cherry action again. It's definitely tart. It's got a lot of acidity here in the middle part of your tongue. On the sides, you can feel that. Let's get another taste. Good finish on this wine. Definitely keeps going. nice silkiness to it. Some nice tannin going on as well. This wine definitely still a little bit young, has the capability to still improve in the bottle. And $45, I'm going 89 points on this wine. Good effort from Carr. And pour the second wine, a little Cabernet Franc going on for wine number two. And so there, 2008 Carr Cabernet Franc from the Camp 4 Vineyard, east end of San Ynez Valley. 100% Cabernet Franc, 370 cases produced, 20 months in French oak, 25% of that being new French oak. Rolls in at $30 US, I believe is the price point on this wine. Let's get things situated. So, interesting story with Carr. Ryan Carr, owner and proprietor of Carr Winery and Vineyards, grew up in Southern California, always had like a little bit of an interest in farming. No aspirations to be a winemaker, never thought of that. Went off to school to Arizona, Arizona State, got a degree in art, came back, moved to San Ynez, started drinking some of the local wines, and like, wow, these wines are really good, and started getting an interest in the viticulture, the farming of the grape up in that area. Got a job with a local vineyard management company, helping out, you know, pruning the vines, and then a year later for harvest, helping out at a co-op, making wines as an assistant and apprentice with some other winemakers, getting his feet wet. And then a year later, he made his first vintage, 10 cases, 120 bottles for friends and family of a Cabernet Sauvignon that right down the road from his house helped grow the grapes and made the wine in his garage. And friends and family loved the wine, and he basically said to himself, this is the way it should be. The grapes, I should grow the grapes, I should produce the wine and sell it, not buying the grapes from somebody else. And that's basically what his idea has been going forward. All the wine that you see here, he owns all the grapes. He's the grower. And so again, that special relationship with the land, the grape, and you know, viticulture in viniculture meeting. So pretty cool. I like that that whole story about Ryan. And look on the wine, a little bit darker. Some air into this. Some wines were sent in as samples for the show. Just wanted to thank Carr and the next wine, Silver, for doing that. Really appreciate it. Let's give it a smell. Wow, so there's a little bit of a trend so far, and the trend is cherry cola. Again, I'm getting that on the nose here. But there's something else going on here. And it's a, wonderful, like a blueberry muffin component, like a freshly baked smell of a blueberry muffin. If you break it open, get your schnoz up in there. Blueberry muffin. It's got that buttery, wonderful, fresh bakedness to it. There is definitely some oak coming through on this wine as well. This would be a killer food wine, I bet, already, just by smelling it. And there's a rustic tartness also coming through on this wine on the nose. So interesting stuff. Let's give it a taste. Wow. Great mouthfeel. I mean, this is definitely like, have you ever heard the comparison of light to full-bodied wines of the scope of non-fat milk to half and half or cream? This is definitely like cream. This is definitely just hanging on the inside of your mouth, on your tongue. It's a heavy mouthfeel. It's luxurious. It has a nice velvety feel to it. Very juicy. Mm. It is great fruit on this wine, some nice round tannins as well, but to me, it is the mouthfeel on this wine that's the kicker. It is just luxurious. It is a first-class ticket all the way. It's interesting, too, is lately some of the Cabernet Francs I've been drinking are from the Loire Valley area of France, and they're much lighter, fruitier, also in color, like not quite as dark, more almost like a Beaujolais sometimes. And so this is definitely a whole different side of the spectrum. So if you're familiar with Loire Valley and the lighter styles of Cabernet Franc, this may be interesting to try out. Definitely a great wine for like a big steak right here. I'll tell you that right now. Wow, I really like what's going on in here. I like the price point as well, $30. It's dynamite. I'm going 91 points on the Cabernet Franc from Carr. And again, it's interesting, 100% Cabernet Franc. A lot of the ones that I've seen in California, they have something else usually blended in, usually not 100% of that grape. So, a little nerdy, fun stuff. And let's move on to wine number three. Wine number three, Saviza, which means wisdom or knowledge in Old Italian. And it's coming from the Silver Winery. This wine has 22 months in 40% New American, 60% seasoned oak. And it's a blend. It's a Super Tuscan style blend. 90% Sangiovese, 5% Cabernet Sauvignon, and 5% Cabernet Franc. And let's give this baby a pour. Ben Silver. From Massachusetts, excuse me, dual degree and what is it? Forget the term, but it's basically like pre-vet. It's like animal science, I think, and I think like art history, like Italian history or something. So he comes out of school, you know, with a dual degree, ends up working as I think like a biologist, scientist, you know, chemist for a Zaccamessa, and starts getting interested in wine, and decides, you know, he wants to do his own thing, and left Zaccamessa and opened a silver winery in Santa Barbara. So interesting stuff. And so in this wine, the appellation is Santa Barbara County. The Sangiovese is coming from the Santa Maria bench. Cabernet Franc and Cabernet Sauvignon coming from the Los Olivos area of Santa Barbara. So just again, nerdy facts if you're keeping score at home. And this wine, I think, rolls in at $30 US. And this wine, one of the things I noticed when I was looking at it, it's not filtered, it's not fined in any way, meaning that when you look at it too, you can see that there's some very small particles. You can see that it's not exactly clear. This probably won't come through on the video, but you can definitely see in person that you would look at this even say like, wow, there's like a little film or a little thing, some stuff going on in there. And that's just you know, the natural aspect of wine. Some winemakers will use a mechanical filtration, some kind of porous sheets of material to get some of these real small particles out of the wine. And then fining, they actually use egg whites in the bottom of the barrels to the proteins from the egg whites. I think it is like pulls out some of these fine materials, and then there's a way to separate that stuff away from the wine so that you're not drinking eggs. So, which is a good thing, by the way. Excited to try a Super Tuscan from Santa Barbara County. I mean, when was the last time you had a Super Tuscan from Santa Barbara County? Probably not yesterday. So let's give it a smell. Yeah, very rustic. You got the Sangiovese coming through. The wine that basically, the grape that made Italy, and that is the premier grape in Italy, and it does quite well actually in California. I've had a lot of great Sangiovese wines. The climate, I guess, just works for it out here. Yeah, this wine's got like some smokiness going on. oaky, a lot of dark fruit coming through. Let's give it a taste. Good mouthfeel, good structure on this wine. Nice, again, rounded tannins, some good acid on the palate. It's finished, still going. Wow, really nice, long finish on this wine. I can still taste the tart fruit coming through on the wine. Beautiful. By the way, Sangiovese is my ultimate go-to pizza wine, by the way. And while we're talking about pizza wines, what is your go-to pizza wine? I know that's kind of a wide spectrum. You can be eating pepperoni, mushroom, barbecue chicken pizza, you know, some of these California pizza kitchen pizzas that are like a tostada pizza or whatever. But generally speaking, when you're just getting a nice, you know, pizza from the Italian joint down the street, little pepperoni action, little plain cheese maybe, what kind of wine do you like? You know, do you have a go-to wine for pizza night? Is there something that you gravitate towards when you think of pizza for wine? Because I know that for me, I sure do. And so I'm going 90 plus points on the Ben Silver Super Tuscan blend. I really like what's going on, and there's a lot of good things happening in Santa Barbara. A lot of exciting wines, a lot of different varietals, a lot of different microclimates, new AVAs popping up like Happy Canyon, where they're doing like Bordeaux red varieties. And so I urge you to check that out, you know, and check these guys out online, silverwines.com, and I think it's Carr Winery. .com as well. And hope you enjoyed the show. And please comment down below. I love it when you get involved in the conversation. And till next time. Cheers.